Mercedes-Benz Trucks recently announced its eActros 600 heavy-duty truck for medium and long-haul trucking applications. Consider it a competitor to Tesla Semi. Both trucks are making waves in the trucking industry, but for different reasons. So let's take a look at it. Now, the need for electric trucks is becoming increasingly urgent. So for example, in California, trucks make up just 1% of vehicles on the road, but contribute significantly to diesel particulate matter emissions into the atmosphere, as well as carbon emissions. And with tighter regulations on the horizon, the alternative to internal combustion engine trucks is becoming increasingly critical. Now, the eActros 600 by Mercedes-Benz aims for more than 80% CO2 savings compared to diesel trucks. With a range of 500 kilometers and a battery capacity exceeding 600 kilowatt hours, it has significant potential to reshape the market. The eActros 600, according to Mercedes-Benz, will be able to do significantly more than 1,000 kilometers per day. And this is made possible by legally mandated driver breaks. So the expectation is that drivers will charge their trucks during those breaks. Now, about 50% of missions in Mercedes-Benz trucks in Europe are shorter than 500 kilometers, which means the charging infrastructure at the depot and at the loading and unloading points is sufficient for the Mercedes-Benz eActros use cases. Also, with the expansion of EV charging infrastructure, that's really going to be key to making this electric truck viable for long distance hauling across Europe. Hello everyone, my name is Mark Weich. Thanks for checking out this video on cleanearth.io. Before we continue, if you haven't already, be sure to hit the like and subscribe button. By doing that, you're really helping us improve what we do here as well as grow our platform. Also, we really appreciate it. So what is the market response to eActros 600? Well, according to Mercedes-Benz Trucks CEO Karen Redstrom, there is high interest in the truck. The company has already received signed letters of intent for a couple of thousand trucks. Now, the price of electric trucks is higher than that of their diesel counterparts, but Mercedes-Benz Trucks believes that the price is not the focus, but the operational costs. And the company says that they believe that electric trucks can be just as cost effective as their diesel counterparts, especially as they work on reducing costs over time. Now, sales of eActros 600 start this year with planned deliveries for the end of 2024. Now, around the economics of trucks, there's still speculation. So Tesla introduced its first production Tesla Semi truck in December 2022. But they didn't disclose specifics around the economics of the truck. Now, Pepsi has deployed Tesla Semis on 100-mile daily routes to stores and 300 to 400-mile routes to warehouses, which seems to be the mission capabilities that Mercedes-Benz is targeting with eActros. Now, the Class A Semis that PepsiCo is using, their Frito-Lay subsidiary, has deployed trucks that operate on 425-mile routes per day without charging. Now, Frito-Lay with its potato chips are assumed to be a relatively light workload for a Class A truck, but Pepsi with its soft drink products present a much heavier workload. Theoretically, Tesla Semi is achieving the claims made by Tesla when it was introduced. With software, powertrain, and battery optimizations, it is quite possible that Tesla can achieve over 500 miles or 800 kilometers on a single charge in Tesla Semi. Now, interestingly, the 500-mile version of Tesla Semi is estimated to have a roughly 900 kilowatt-hour battery capacity. So I'm not sure how Mercedes-Benz intends to achieve a similar hauling capacity as Tesla Semi with a battery that's two-thirds the size. Also, in terms of economics, Tesla Semi, as I mentioned previously, hasn't really offered sort of the economics of Tesla Semi, whereas Mercedes-Benz Trucks is being a bit more transparent. Now, according to Redstrom, making the electric truck, the focus is not just on a green option, but a financially sensible option as well. So Mercedes-Benz Trucks is working hard on the profitability factor and closing the gap between electric trucks and diesel trucks. Now, in terms of sort of the competitive landscape, Radstrom believes that the eActros 600 is competitively positioned in terms of range, payload, and durability. She did acknowledge the competition. Now, without getting into specifically who they are, Mercedes-Benz Trucks remains confident in their ability to remain competitive, citing their future pipeline. According to Mercedes-Benz Trucks, the eActros 600 will support the megawatt charging standard, or MCS. Now, that standard has not been approved, but for customers who are ordering eActros 600, they can order megawatt charging capability. And once the standard is approved, Mercedes-Benz will offer a retrofit for eActros 600 to support the MCS standard. Now, once that standard is approved, the truck, the eActros 600 truck, will be able to be charged from roughly 20 to 80% in about 30 minutes with around 1 megawatt charging output. So the future of electric trucks is bright. Mercedes-Benz eActros 600 and Tesla Semi are poised to play significant roles in sort of the transition from diesel to electric trucks. Now, there's varied focus on range, economics, and the capabilities, but both companies have unique offerings that promise to really transform the industry. So what do you think about eActros 600, Tesla Semi, and the future of electric trucks? Do you think the economics for electric trucks will provide advantages over their diesel counterparts? And what about day-to-day operation of electric trucks? Electric trucks have massive batteries, and the EV charging infrastructure is still insufficient for many cars. So what are some possible solutions for trucks? Do you know of any currently that are in place? So thanks for checking out this video, and be sure to leave your comments and questions below. Also, be sure to hit those like and subscribe buttons and check back with us for more updates. So thanks for watching this video, and see you in the next one.